Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Math. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we are solving quadratic inequalities. In order to be able to do that, you need to be super good at sketching quadratic graphs. So pause the video and sketch that quadratic graph. Right, how would you do that? Well, what you would do is you would try and find the y-intercept. The y-intercept is where x is equal to 0. If you substitute x is equal to 0 in here, you get y is equal to negative 8. So you know the curve goes through 0, negative 8. You would then try and solve the equation where y is equal to 0 to find the x-intercepts. So you would solve 0 is equal to x squared subtract 2x subtract 8, making y be 0 here. And you would try to factorize that. So you would say 0 is equal to x subtract 4, x add 2, that factorizes as. So you get two answers, x is 4, or x is negative 2. And that tells you that when y is 0, x is 4, so it goes through 4, 0. And when y is 0, x is negative 2, so it goes through negative 2, 0. The last thing is we know it's a positive x squared, so we know it's a u-shaped graph. And that gives us everything we need at this point. So let's label in the y-intercept. The y-intercept's at 0, negative 8, somewhere down here. The x-intercepts are 4, 0 and negative 2, 0. So and we know it's a U-shape, so it's going to go through these points in a U as best we can, something like this. Okay, and you're going to need to be able to do that really well for this particular skill. So let me now use the graph we've just drawn to try and answer some quadratic inequality questions, inequalities involving x squared. I've actually drawn the same graph on the next page, but just nice and neat for us. So here's the exact same graph. It is the graph of y equals x squared subtract 2x subtract 8. Suppose I ask you the following question. When is 0 less than x squared subtract 2x subtract 8? Or suppose I ask you a different style of question. When is x squared subtract 2x subtract 8 less than or equal to 0? What is in green and blue is the style of questions that will come up. There won't be a picture on the page. You'll be asked something like this and you'll be asked to solve for x for those. Now the first thing you do is you're going to draw the graph of y is equal to x squared subtract 2x subtract 8, which we've got already drawn for us. Then what you're going to do is think to yourself, well, solving 0 less than x squared subtract 2x subtract 8, because y is equal to this, this is the same as solving 0 less than y, or answering the question, where is y bigger than 0 on my graph? Where are, and could we highlight, on the graph, where is y bigger than 0? Well, y is bigger than 0 here, along here, and along here, isn't it? All the y values along there are bigger than 0. Down here, they're less than 0. Now, we're trying to solve this for x. What x values make y bigger than 0? Well, they're all these values, aren't they? They're all the values to the left here and all the values to the right here. So if we were solving it and we had drawn the graph, we could say it's x less than negative 2, and we could say it's x bigger than 4. And because we've got a strict inequality here, we use strict inequalities here and here. So that seems good enough. Now, imagine someone asked you a different question. When is x squared subtract 2x subtract 8 less than or equal to 0? You draw the graph y equals x squared subtract 2x subtract 8. You'd think, well, therefore I'm going to convert this into the question, when is my y is less than or equal to 0 on the graph I've drawn? Well, clearly, they're here. The y's are less than or equal to 0 down along here. Now, what x values match that? Well, they're all the x's between here and here, aren't they? So they are going to be the x's between 4 and negative 2. And because we've got a less than or equal to sign here, we're going to use those type of inequalities. So x less than or equal to positive 4, bigger than or equal to negative 2. And that's how we're going to solve these. Someone's going to give us a question like this or like this. Step one, we're going to draw the graphs. We're going to convert it into trying to think about where the graph is above or below the x-axis. And that's how we're going to find our x values. Right, let's give a question a go. Solve x squared at 5x subtract 14 is less than 0. The first thing we're going to do, stage one, is we're going to draw the graph y is equal to x squared add 5x subtract 14. The first thing we're going to do is work out the y-intercept. When x is equal to 0, substituting 0 in here, we're going to get y is negative 14. So we know it goes through 0, negative 14. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to let y is equal to 0. And we're going to try and solve the equation 0 equals x squared add 5x take away 14. We solve that by attempting to factorise, and it factorises as x add 7, x subtract 2, and that tells us that we get values x is negative 7 or x is positive 2 when we solve. So we know that our x-intercepts, as it were, are negative 7, 0 and 2, 0, like that. So we know it goes through those points. And lastly, we know it's a U-shaped graph. So let's draw that. So drawing our U-shaped graph, it would be something like this. Okay, and remember now, we're trying to solve where our graph, this remember is the graph we've drawn, where our graph y is less than 0. Where is the y values less than 0? They are less than 0 along below here. Where is y below the axis? There. And you can just see that they are the x values between 2 and negative 7. Because we've got a strict inequality sign, we use a strict inequality sign, and that is our solution to this question, and we're done. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go at this one. Now, we can use the exact same graph as we used before. We want to draw the graph y is equal to x squared add 5x subtract 14. We can use the same graph we did before. Now we're looking this time where our graph, where this our y graph is bigger than or equal to 0. Where is that happening? Well, where are the y numbers on the red line are bigger than 0? Well, here and along here, aren't they? So for this point here, it's x, it's all the x's this side, it's the x's that are less than negative 7, and it's all the x's this side here, x's bigger than positive 2. And we use a less than or equal to sign and a bigger than or equal to sign because we look back at our original question and they used that sign there, so we must use that sign. If that was a strict inequality, we'd use a strict inequality. And there is the answer for this particular question. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go. Now, what graph am I going to draw here? Well, remember guys, when we're drawing graphs and solving quadratics and trying to find their roots or x-intercepts and y-intercepts, we must have one side equal 0. So before we even solve this inequality, let's add 6 to both sides in order to make one side 0. So we're going to have x squared add 9x add 20 is going to be less than or equal to 0. Now let's try and draw the graph y is equal to x squared add 9x add 20 and use that to solve this inequality here. So how do we do that? Well, step one, we try and find the y-intercept. When x is equal to 0, y, substituting 0 in there for x, we get y is 20. So we know it goes through 0, 20. Step two, we try and solve when y is 0 to find the x-intercepts. We're going to solve 0 equals x squared add 9x add 20. We're going to try and solve by factorising, which we can. It factorises to x add 4, x add 5. That gives us two answers for x. X is negative 4 or x is equal to negative 5. So there are x-intercepts. And lastly, we know it's U-shaped because it's positive x squared. So let's label those points in here. We know it goes through 0, 20, which we're going to put up there. We also know it goes through negative 4, 0, somewhere like there, and we also know it goes through negative 5, 0, somewhere like there, and it's U-shaped, so it's going to look something like this, okay, very roughly something like that. Now, what are we trying to solve? We're trying to solve this here. We rearranged this, so always look back at what we changed it to. We're trying to solve this, our graph, our y, less than or equal to 0. Where is our graph, our red line, our y values for that red line, less than or equal to 0, or between here and here. So therefore the x values between negative 4 and negative 5. And because we used a less than or equal to sign, we'll say less than or equal to, less than or equal to, and that's our answer here. So x is less than or equal to negative 4, but bigger than or equal to negative 5 is our answer. One more. So make sure you've had a go at this. Remember, I'm not going to try and do anything with this until I make one side equal to 0. So I'm going to subtract 3x off both sides. I'm also going to subtract 7 off both sides. And I'm going to tidy up, and that's the graph I'm going to draw. Now I'm going to draw the graph. This is the graph I'm interested in. y is equal to x squared, add 6x, subtract 27. Let's do each stage. Let's get the y-intercept. When x is 0, y would be negative 27, so it goes through 0, negative 27. Then we're going to make y equal 0 and solve 0 is equal to x squared, add 6x, subtract 27. Factorizing that, it works out nicely as x add 9, x subtract 3. Therefore, we're going to get the answers x is negative 9, x is positive 3. So we know it goes through negative 9, 0, and it also goes through positive 3, 0. And lastly, we know it's u-shaped. So let's plot these points. And we are looking for, let's go back up here, where our graph is less than or equal to 0. So we are looking for our graph here, where the y values are less than or equal to 0. And therefore, that's going to be x. And between the values 3 and negative 9, because we're dealing with a less than or equal to sign, we're going to have less than or equal to, less and bigger than or equal to there. And that is our answer for this question. And we're done.